these packs and open them, and therefore there's more players on the market. So what happens after that is the prices come down as everyone lists their players and tries to undercut the cheapest one, and so the price has to fall. This is generally, I think it's the lowest that the players go, especially at least until maybe March or April maybe, when they just naturally come down and there's less players and more players are on the market. But I think now it's the cheapest. I was thinking about investing in some players and then selling them on a few weeks later, but when I looked at decreasing the player prices, this is the cheapest to buy them, so I might as well build a good team and then just stick with that, and the price will naturally go up. What I will be doing is keeping my two squads, which are these two. The players aren't worth much in them anyway. None of these players are worth too much, and to be honest, I'm not really enjoying using any of them at the minute. I'm really struggling through the weekend league with them just to get wins. And then this is my other team, which I've changed around a little bit since my last video. I think the other one has completely changed because I had some Calcio A players and things like that. But yeah, this one's okay, but it's, again, it's not great. You can tell the quality of the players compared to other people that I'm coming against just isn't good enough. But hopefully that will change soon. But what I am going to do is just wait, because I can almost afford the team that I want to build. So I'm going to build that team, leave these players in my club, wait until middle of December when they go up in price, and I leave, and then sell them then, rather than now while they're crashing in price and people may be undercutting them and they're maybe more difficult to sell. So yeah, I'm just going to make a squad based around players that the squad that I'd like to build that I've looked at, and then I can talk you through why and what the prices were and what they're hopefully going to fall to. I've got my laptop here as well, so I'll be going through I'll be going through Footbin maybe to check what the price is currently of them. Just call the squad market crash. My PlayStation's being quite loud now, so I hope that's not causing too much of a distraction. Okay, so the formation that I like to play is 4-1-2-1-2-2, so with the midfielders. Currently I'm playing 4-3-3, just because I find good strikers to be expensive, so I play with decent wingers that can work and are a lot cheaper, still with good stats, and then I change formation in game. But hopefully I won't need to do that going forward. So I'm going to start from the back. The first position is goalkeeper. I may swap depending on coins. There's two positions that I'm quite happy to sacrifice on, because I think there's cheaper players that are nearly as good. But yeah, hopefully I won't need to, and the prices will come down. But yeah, we'll see. So the first player and who I'm going to have in goal, although I haven't seen many people use him, is Thibaut Courtois. 89 rated. I think he'll be pretty good. The player that I may switch him out for, if his price is too high, is Peter Cech. He is, when I played against him and other people have used him, I think he's a lot cheaper. I'm not sure of his price, but when I've played against people with Peter Cech, he's been amazing. So maybe I'll use him, but for now Thibaut Courtois. I'm not sure. I don't think I can afford De Gea, otherwise he may be a good option, but I've used him. 72. Let's just have a look. He's been going, that's just been dropping gradually. He was 69 yesterday. So, having looked at last year, I think a lot of people think that the crash is going to happen on the 25th. But when I looked at last year's player prices, I found that in the big players, they all dropped on the Monday before. So that's after the Champions weekend. On the Sunday, everyone sells their players. So Monday, everyone's really cheap. And everyone's expecting to sell their players and buy them back on the Friday for cheap. But by that point, they've actually risen a little bit. So I think the Monday before, which I think this year's the 20th of November, is the day I'm going to look to buy, because some of these players have come down in price quite a lot, but I still think they can come down a little bit more. So Courtois will be in there, and he's currently 72,000, and I'm looking to get him for 57 to 60, I would say would be a good price. The next position at left back is a player that's quite expensive. Absolutely terrible. was 90k on the 6th, the 11th, and I'd like to get him for about 63, and currently he's going for 83, so again, quite a way off, but I'm hoping that he comes down a fair bit. Eric Bailly, he was 50,000 on the 6th. I think this is one of the players that is actually nearly there. So he is 40, but I think he was less yesterday after everyone was panic selling. 37 yesterday, yeah. So I think he will come down again after this weekend. And goal. He 42 on the 11th. I'm looking to get him for 30. He's very close, he's at 32. 750. Well, he's actually at 34. That one must have just been a cheap one listed up. The next player and the first midfielder, one of my favourite players the last couple of years, and insane on the game last year and this year, probably the workhorse, N'Golo Kanté. His stats, 81 base, not a massive improvement on last year, but I think he'll play a really willing game. 81 pace, 80 dribbling, his shot's a bit low, but he'll never go forward when I play with him generally. 75 passing, which I might try and improve a little bit. 81 defending, 84 physical. He's just going to run around collecting everything for me, I hope. So yeah, that's my aim for Kanté. His stats look a bit hit and miss in some places. Free kick accuracy, I don't really care. Agility is really good though, and balance, which I think is really important to turn and chase people, which is his strength. Defending, standing tackle 89, sorry, slide tackle 85, interceptions 91, which is perfect, heading accuracy 54, which is a bit of a letdown, but hopefully you won't have to do too much in that department. I'll go through all the prices again in a minute once I've completed the midfield. So the next person here, this person could change, but if they play well, I think it would work, but I'm not sure. It might be, I like quite a physical midfield, so he's already got in form. Christian Eriksen. Again, just a great all-round player, I think he's going to really help out the team. I will need to put maybe a shadow on him to boost his pace and defending. Or maybe like a guardian or something. He's the one player I'm a bit uncertain of. Ideally he would be replaced with Pogba, but Pogba is just way too expensive. But I think he'll be a good player, and I think he'll be able to just do enough in that role, especially with the player that I'm using here, which is Roger Nainggolan. This card I had on a loan, and he's just phenomenal. 78 pace, 80 shooting, 78 passing, 82 dribbling, 81 defending, 83 physical. With him and Kanté, I think Eriksen will be allowed to roam a little bit and have cover even if he's not strong enough or doesn't win the ball in the right areas. I might replace Eriksen with Dele Alli, I'm not sure yet, we'll see. I don't really like Dele Alli, so hopefully not. Gonna have to change him, but if he's not playing well, then I will change him out. So yeah, I mean, just add an attribute card, so his pace and passing are up, and he's in the Hulik club, as they call it, the everything above 80. Let's just have a look in game. All green, the odd yellow, heading accuracy, don't care. Free kick accuracy, don't care. Penalties, don't care. Everything else, he's just smashing it. So I'm really excited to have that card. That's a card that I definitely will be getting. So yeah, I'm really excited for that. And I'll go through the prices of these, and then I'll do the front three. So Nainggolan is 218k on the 6th of the 11th. based on previous years, they, from what I looked at, they came down about 25%. Some of the big players, maybe not the likes of Messi, they did drop a massive amount, but percentage wise, not as much, but in value more, if that makes sense. And Ericsson was 87 on the 6th of this month. I'd like to get him for about 61. I think he was close to that yesterday. He was 75, and yesterday he was 69. So I think he will be close next Monday. I'm really hoping so anyway, so I can afford this team. If not, I think Dele Alli's cheaper. I might just get him and he can run around like a headless chicken. That's fine. So maybe we'll get Dele Alli and put him here. Christian.